think about a car going down a road. The road's got rocks and cracks and potholes and things in it, and part of the car's infrastructure, if you will, is to have the ability to smooth out the ride, make it more comfortable. So we've got a tire and a wheel going over this road, but inside the car's suspension, we also have shock absorbers. We have something that's going to smooth the ride. So the road may be cracky and rough, but what we actually feel might be smoother. And this smoothing that the suspension does and the shock absorbers do on the car is going to be like a filter we might use in surface texture analysis. Let's look at a surface that has some waviness, and our goal is to measure roughness. Now, to measure roughness, we need to remove the waves so we can see the fuzz, if you will. So if I were to look at this surface on the right, I would want to smooth through this surface, and this red graph I'm creating is the waviness profile, and the things that are left over, the high frequency or the short wavelength shape, is the roughness. So the job of a filter in surface finish is to act like a shock absorber. The filter is going to kind of smooth out the ride. It's going to look at a zone of data here and plot the average, and then move over a little bit and plot the average and plot the average, and average out the surface into something smooth that we would call waviness. Now, when we take away waviness, we're left with roughness. And that's often the thing we care most about, but waviness is important also for things like vibration. The car's shock absorber is a mechanical filter. In the world of surface texture, we don't use mechanical filters so much. In fact, our stylus tip is so small, we try to get it out of the way and not have any mechanical filtering. Instead, we want to use mathematical filtering in surface texture. So like I mentioned above, we want to use some kind of moving average. We want to average to get to the waviness, and then we can take the waviness away. Now, to do a filter in the optimal way, this average is very important. Think of our goal. We have short wavelengths that we want to separate from long wavelengths. So if we make the wavelength graph over here, waviness should be 100% of these and 0% of these. If I were to plot waviness, I want all of the long wavelengths and none of the short wavelengths. In reality, we can't be perfect. The best we can do is a filter that might look something like this, where 50% gets through at our cutoff wavelength. Now, the cutoff wavelength might be 0.8 millimeters or 30 thousandths of an inch, and the sharpest filter we can use or create mathematically to do this is called the Gaussian filter. The Gaussian filter is going to use a different kind of moving average. It's a moving average that's shaped a little more like the normal distribution. In fact, it is exactly the normal distribution. The Gaussian filter is a bell curve that's averaged through our data. The points in the middle get a little extra credit, and the points on the edges get virtually no credit. In fact, if we were to choose a filter of, say, 0.8 millimeters wavelength, in general, this width would be 0.8 millimeters wide. And we would average this through the data to create waviness. If we changed our filter cutoff to 2.5 millimeters, then the width of the bell curve becomes 2.5 millimeters. And this is why when we make a measurement, we have to throw away points at the end, because when I calculate my first average underneath this curve, the first result I get is going to be when the curve sits right here. And then I'll slide this all the way through, and the last result I'll get will be right over here, where I still have some points on both sides for my average. So the Gaussian filter typically discards 1/2 of a cutoff on each end of the data. This amount of surface goes away because it's needed for the filter. So if you're looking inside your gauge, wondering what these things mean, know this. Number one, we need to filter in order to understand roughness. We need to filter to create a waviness profile that gets subtracted, and the leftovers are roughness. Just like in this picture, we want this to be as sharp as possible. We want our car ride to be as smooth as possible without any extra bouncing. And when we do this, mathematically, we need to use a Gaussian filter. We slide that through the surface, and the Gaussian filter gives us the best possible separation of roughness and waviness. Now, there are other filters like the robust filter that we've talked about in another video. If you have questions about filtering or anything regarding interpreting and understanding your data, feel free to reach out to us at digitalmetrology.com. We just love talking about this stuff, and we'll be glad to help.